Hello, today we are going to discuss nuclear reactions. These nuclear reactions are fission and fusion. So we shall discuss now what is fission, what is fusion, and the reactions as source of energy. First we talk about fission. When atoms are bombarded with neutrons, their nuclei split into two parts which are roughly in equal size. Nuclear fission is division of heavy nucleus into two approximately equal parts with release of energy. During nuclear fission, neutrons are released that give chain reaction. You see now neutron incident on uranium. It absorbs the neutron, it becomes excited, and now it undergoes fission into two fragments with release of three neutrons. These three neutrons, they interact with these are the examples of nuclear fission. Uranium, it absorbs neutron, gives barium and krypton. This is a chain reaction. We can see now in fission, two neutrons are given out, two or three neutrons. These neutrons interact with other uranium nuclei and they undergo fission and the reaction continues. It is called fission, chain reaction. Now we calculate the energy released in fission. Now here, when fission takes place, both fission fragments and neutrons travel at high speed. The kinetic energy of products of fission are far greater than that of bombarding neutron and target atom. This difference in the kinetic energy is released as the fission energy. Now the energy can be calculated by using the relation equal to mc square, mass energy relation, very famous relation, where m is the mass difference in the product and reacting nuclei, reacting particles, and c the velocity of light in vacuum. Now let us calculate the energy released for fission. For example, we consider this reaction. This is the mass of uranium, mass of neutron. This is the mass of bromium, krypton and 3 neutrons, and so we get the mass effect 0.222 atomic mass unit. So the energy released is approximately 200 mega electron volt. The energy released from this fission reaction, we may see it is very small because we are considering only a one nucleus. And the energy per nucleus is only 200 mega electron volt. But if we consider the mass, certain mass, then it seems to be very large energy, large amount of energy. And we can calculate now what is the energy given by 1 kg of uranium. Now we know this is the energy given by 1 uranium nucleus. Number of atoms present in 1 kg atom, 1 kg atom, that is 235 kg of uranium, is Avogadro number. So this is the energy given by 235 kg of uranium, 1.93 into 10 to 16 joule. So energy given by 1 kg of uranium is 8.2 into 10 to 13 joule, and it comes out to be 10 to 3 megawatt day. So if we convert this energy into electric energy with 30% efficiency, we get 300 megawatt day. In thermal power plant, 3000 tons of coal is required to generate this amount of energy. So now we may say that 1 kg of uranium is equivalent to 3000 tons of coal, and now we can conclude it is very powerful source of energy. This was about fission, and now we come to next nuclear reaction, that is nuclear fusion. To fuse means to combine. So in nuclear fusion, two nuclei with low mass number, lighter nuclei, they combine to produce heavy nucleus with higher mass and again with release of energy. So one example of nuclear fusion, this is the controlled thermonuclear reaction. Deuterium, tritium, these are isotopes of hydrogen. They fuse to give helium, neutron and energy. This is the fusion, deuterium, tritium, they combine. The fusion, we get helium, neutron and energy. Now we calculate energy released in fusion. We use the same method, that is mass defect. These are the masses of reacting and product particles. We use the same method, we calculate the mass difference and then we calculate energy released per fusion. The total mass before fusion is this 8.353 into 10 raised to minus 27 kg. After fusion, it is 8.322 into 10 raised to minus 27. We see it is less energy. So that's the mass difference. The mass difference comes out to be 3.1 into 10 raised to minus 29 kg. And now we calculate the energy that comes out to be 2.79 into 10 raised to minus 12 joule. Okay. If we compare the two energies, see the energy released per fission is 3.2 into 10 raised to minus 11 joule, while energy in one fusion reaction is 2.79 into 10 raised to minus 12 joule. It seems to be less. But actually, if we compare the energy released per nucleon, then energy released per nucleon, here we are using only 5 nucleons, while in fission we are using 35 nucleons. So energy released per nucleon in fission, it comes out to be 0.85, while in fusion it comes out to be 6.7 mega electron volt. And so we can say that fusion is more powerful than fission. Thank you very much.